All right, here we are. We're going to have a match between Malvolio and Frizzler for the fourth round of the Board Game Geek Tournament. With me is Andrew once more.
Hello, everybody.
And we're hoping to see a different matchup than Whale and Criminal, and also a more interesting game.
I think we can like sponsor some players. We pay them money so that they play different factions. Maybe we talk to Red Bull so that they sponsor the Shapers because they have diesel and something. They'll burn.
Okay, one part of the combination is here and has Byroid. I think in the finals. And one good idea would be to have the player hand be hidden, and then to which way we can stream it live. And I won't be afraid that somebody from the players is going to log in and see the opponent's hand.
Probably a good idea. Makes it more tense for us too. It's like you get rid of our commentary. Oh, I would have done that because we just see the cards. Yeah, then we could do that.
Yep. So, quite an interesting start for Fabian Fritzl. He's got the money. Question is, will he be able to protect it?
Yeah, he might. It's a good start. It's a pretty good start. And the criminals have a pretty good... Malvolio has a pretty good start, too. So.
Yeah, very strong.
It's an interesting game, I think.
Very, very strong economy at the start for Malvolio, I think.
Yeah, two pretty good starting hands.
Problem is that it's very likely that as soon as Fritzl plays his Wall of Ice, Malvolio is going to look for the Corroder.
Yeah, but maybe, yeah. We'll see where he plays it.
Mm.
And that depends a lot. He does have that itchy too, which can be quite punishing.
Problem is itchy doesn't do anything at the start of the game. So you want to play itchy as soon as you've played some programs. And you'd also
but if he goes for the Corroder, then the AG comes into play.
Mm. So he went with the ice walls.
I always dislike it when I have like doubles of the
of the same type.
Of the same type, yeah. Mm. Especially the cheap ones. It's like if I have Enigma and Enigma, or Wall of Static and Wall of Static, or two Ice Walls.
Mm.
It's not, yeah.
Not optimal,
it's
yeah.
If I have one and the other.
Yeah. So we're going to see straight up showing them.
Yeah, and we're going to see that Corroder pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm,
because, yeah, he's going to run on HQ now.
Yeah. Next play is going to be Corroder immediately. And then Fritzler will be too poor to play anything else. Probably he's going to try to play that Itzy in front, maybe. We'll have to see. Now, Malvolio is definitely going to be cackling with glee. As he can
He has a big grin on his face right now.
Just grab that Corroder, play that... Desperado down and go to town.
Yeah, but he's doing the right thing, I think. He's putting the Armitage. Yeah, that's how I play when I do it too.
Mm.
Don't do it at the end because he doesn't know you have it.
Obviously,
buy some time. Do it at the start of next turn.
Exactly, and you have the money to break in as soon as possible. So let's see how he's going to play this. The problem is that he's totally poor at the moment. So there's not a lot of options.
On Heimdall?
I really like it. It's really good at stopping actually access to one server. Because to actually pass the Heimdall, you need your whole turn. So most people are not prepared. to actually do that, especially if you're running random opus and stuff. So even though most people can just bypass it if they really need to, most people don't. And in my Stronger Together has Bayer, Heimdall is pretty much impassable for most people.
Yeah, I really think you have to play him right, and he's definitely not like an early game ice.
Mm. No, I mean, it's very good to have him. I think very good combo is to have Ichi Heimdall, if you can do it, and if possible have Ichi behind Heimdall. As soon as they pass Heimdall with clicks, spring an Ichi on them, and it's really difficult then to escape.
Yeah, that is a very good move.
Problem is, you also do not want Ichi to be as the last ice, because they can just take all the subroutines.
If you do it reverse, it's not that bad, because Heimdall does have the one brain damage.
You don't
do the trash program and stuff anymore, but you do some damage.
Yeah, but usually one brain damage is not enough. No?
Yeah, it's not that big of a surprise element.
Yeah. Putting that Ichi there is a pretty good idea. But the problem is that he's going to run, criminal usually runs on his first click against Haspiro, so it's very difficult to find the correct time to spring that Ichi.
Yeah, I think the criminal is going to go for that Corroder, and Maker's Eye.
Yeah, we're going to see Corroder and Maker's Eye most likely. And it's going to be brutal because we have seen only one agenda, so there's a lot of them waiting.
It's like, yeah, access to R&D is so important in this game. Even if he doesn't get any agenda, he knows what cards he's getting next. Mm. Yeah.
Let's see if he's managed to snipe that that agenda from the hand. It's 1 in 5. People always manage to do that with me. Let's see the same here.
Yeah, and it's a free run, basically, because actually, no, he gains one credit.
Mm-hmm.
Desperado, yeah. Let's see. No.
He has
a toll booth at least. Yeah, it's
information. Yeah. Never a bad thing to have. Let's see if he's going to go for that Maker's Eye now.
I would go for it.
Yeah, it's totally worth it.
Especially when you see like stuff like a toll booth, because you know that that might come down on R&D.
Mm-hmm.
So you know that there's going to be ice that's going to stop you. So
do it
when you can.
Oh, brutal.
Keep streaming out.
That was brutal. Just at the perfect moment to steal that. And he's now only needs the one agenda that Fritzler has in his hand. He's going to win with 0 points. That was nasty.
Yeah, and he tries to corporate troubleshoot.
And
good run.
Well, the good thing is that he has the archive memos. He can get a corporate troubleshooter back. Problem is, he doesn't have the money to protect it. Let's see if he's going to go. I would probably go at this moment for Tollbooth Melange, but let's see how he plays it. It's not worth it trying to put that agenda down, because one inside jab can be the end of you, especially when the other player has 2-4 points already.
Yeah. But there's another problem. He has to worry about his R&D too now. Because all the cards on his R&D, they were like stolen or trashed. He drew the hedge fund, which was the non-trashable one. So he knows he needs to protect that one too.
Yeah, he's going to put that. Okay.
Pleasant position.
So that Heimdall there is going to slow down the HQ access. And I'm suspecting we're going to see that Tollbooth come down as well. And then take a credit. Oh, no, sorry.
I think he wants to be able to res both of them if he puts both of them down, because, you know, force activation orders is always a threat, and he needs both that Heimdall and the Tollbooth.
Yeah, true.
He can't afford to lose one to force activation.
Unfortunately, if the criminal sees that Tollbooth is going to use the Femme Fatale immediately on it, so.
Yeah, and he probably did it as a bit of a bluff too, and meaning that he wants Malvolio to think that he put down the Tollbooth, because he did see the Tollbooth. Oh, okay, so he is putting it down. There you go. Okay. There goes my math.
Well, He doesn't care about that Melan so much, apparently. Personally, I would probably have kept it. Because a Snictor Beta, if he managed to pull a Snictor Beta, you want card as a buffer in your hand. Very nice, he got some extra money. Yeah, very bad situation to be in for Frizzler. Those 4 points at the start of the game is brutal. Especially when you're holding a 3-pointer in your hand. Oh, that asset might actually be useful. You can actually play a naked ass with Melange if you know you can survive for one turn. Let's see. Probably waiting for the next piece of ice now.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. It was the next piece of ice.
What I'm suspecting is going to happen. He's going to put the next piece of ice with us and maybe the agenda and hope he can use it before he gets inside jobbed. And if he gets inside up, he's going to use the us and then hope he won't get the breaker. Oh, there comes the E3 implants. All criminals are packing them because it's such a counter meta to Cast Bioread, which is the second strongest corporation at the moment. Okay, yeah. Exposing the ice.
Yeah, he's afraid. He wants to know where the toll booth is, pretty much.
Probably.
Yeah, we're gonna see. Next turn, we're probably going to see that Femme Fatale go down.
Oh, so much money for the criminal.
Yeah. It pays to be a crook, apparently.
It does always.
Crime does pay.
Crime does pay very much in the world of Android Netrunner. Oh, that sentry is going to be nice if he can get it before that nasty lady comes out. And do actually something with it. Suspect he's going to try and put it down and maybe make Marvolio face check it. If he can actually get Marvolio to face check that Rototara, is going to be quite good.
Yeah, definitely. And it's still a pretty good idea.
Yeah, I'm suspecting Rototara, us, and Melange.
Yeah, that's my guess too. I don't think he's. Bold enough to put the agenda.
No,
it, so
it's such a big risk.
I think they'll put down the melange.
Forgot to actually put music. Oh well, next game.
You don't want me to sing. I'm not very talented. Yeah, the problem is. We're gonna see that Femme Fatale go down. Toll booth costs just one now. Well, of that, it costs two. And all Malvolio needs is a 3-point agenda from that R&D. So, yeah. I really hate these situations where the runner is one, can be one agenda away.
I'd actually forgotten to put my channel on private, so I did it now.
Yeah, that was a good move with the melange and the ash.
Yeah,
how this goes.
Let's see if he can think to sneak door it. Ooh, nasty! But he does have that. He does have the Heimdall protecting, but it's going to be brutal. Is he going to face check it?
Yeah, he wants him to res it. That's the whole
thing. I wouldn't res it.
If he doesn't res, he can go through. If he does res, it makes him pay. And
nah.
I think that's a good idea because he does have the melange anyway. So.
But then he's going to siphon him, I think.
Not this turn.
Yeah, so, yeah, he can get that Melange out now. It is perfect at the moment. He really needs that money. And he has a pretty empty hand as well. Ooh, two agendas in the hand. Ooh. Well, at least he won't lose if he steals the two-pointer, so that's something.
Yeah, at least then.
There we go. Some money. Malvolio really needs now to get rid of that Melange because his advantage might really quickly dissipate if he actually makes that money out.
Yeah, and if he manages to score that mandatory upgrade, oh boy, that is so awesome.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to see some long-term money advantage here. Let's see if he's going to Melange again. I would. Gathering some ice. Well, not that kind of ice. But still, hand buffer. And inside zap protection. So it's always good. Quite a lot of barriers so in Fritz's deck.
Yeah, and he goes for the easy Melange money. Mm. Might as well use it while you can.
Yeah. That T3 is so brutal against Hasbiroid. That's why Hasbiroid is now playing without Biroids. It's a very shifting meta. If Biroid becomes too powerful, people start including E3s. If it doesn't, people remove them.
Yeah, I only play like one copy in my deck.
Yeah, most people play.
When I play with, when I play with my friends, like when I play casual games, I just take it out if they're playing Hasbiroid.
Well, if it has a legitimate reason in your deck, it's not as a hate card. If you're playing, for example, with your Auroras and with your whatevers, then yeah.
Aurora, Peacock, stuff like that.
But otherwise, it's just, counter card. It's a hate card. And it's really brutal against Hasbiroid.
Yeah,
I believe
that's why I don't like it and I don't...
They should really...
I think it's very powerful.
They shouldn't have made that ruling this way. They shouldn't have made it so that it can trigger off itself.
Yeah, that is definitely true. I agree with that one.
Okay, now he can pass through that Roto turret as well. Why did he just remove one? Maybe he just faster for him. Let's see. Still, it's 3 credits per run. It's a decent amount. Credits.
It's well worth it. At this point, it is well worth it.
Yeah, 2 credits with the Desperado, obviously. Oh, come on.
Oh, man.
Such good luck.
Yeah. That was a bit too short.
Okay, so let's go to the next.